I will say, I could just eat the roasted carrots. Like, I would just eat them as a
I could eat the roasted carrots, too. I'm hungry for fall.
Hi, and welcome back to Chemists in the Kitchen. Today, we're really excited to be making some delicious soup. We are going to be looking at a very humble vegetable of a carrot, and we're going to see what happens to that carrot over the process of cooking it. Whether boiling or roasting it will give us some better flavors when we're actually making the soup. I am Julie Pollack, and I am an associate professor of chemistry at the University of Richmond.
My name is Robin Mays. I'm a chemical engineer, and I do research and analysis on science and technology policy.
Hi, my name is Adrian DeFonte. I'm a scientist, and I work for a medical device company.
So we're going to make two different carrot soups today. One where we're actually going to take the carrots and roast them first in the oven. And in this process, hopefully we will get some caramelization on the carrots itself. The other carrots we're going to take and just boil them to make them soft enough. And then we're going to put both of them together in two separate pots. We're going to make the whole base of the soup, which is going to include some onions, some garlic, some more seasonings, and some vegetable broth. Along the whole process, we're gonna make sure that we're tasting it, we're seeing how the taste of the carrot changes, whether it's being boiled or roasted, and as we start to cook it in the oils and with the onion and the garlic and start to build some of the aromatics and how that can change the flavor profile.
So I'm expecting that the roasted carrot soup is gonna be my favorite. Roasting vegetables is magical. Even though air is a pretty bad conductor of heat, there's so many opportunities for more chemical reactions with exposure to oxygen, right? So usually when you boil vegetables, they do get softer, things are happening, but you're not getting the same set of reactions that you would get in air or in oil. There's the heat transfer element and there's the chemical reaction element, and I think the roasted carrot soup is gonna be awesome.
And I would say it's like, I think we're thinking about the profile flavor is like, you have a chemical reaction, you go A to B. But I think in roasting, it's gonna go A to B to C to D. Actually, it's gonna be a multitude, a diversity of chemical reactions. And it's actually that type of diversity that kind of gives it that depth of flavor that you're trying to experience.
I got these at the farmer's market. They're
You did?
Oh, delicious,
wow.
Yeah.
I just bought mine from the grocery store, plain old cheapest 2-pound thing of carrots that I could get.
Yeah, I got the fancy carrots, so I got the ones that come in all different colors.
I have pre-cut my carrots, but why don't you guys get to cutting?
So I'm ready to roast my carrots.
You guys put in a little bit of olive oil and some salt on them?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
That's what I'm doing too. All right, we going in, 400?
All right, so we'll taste these ones. All right, let's start. Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of sweet and woodsy.
It's sweet, a little bit tangy. Feels a little tangy, sweet, but like tangy, right?
I think that's the initial part, right? Is that the yep. process is actually supposed to, the sugars are the part that we're trying to like break down. Overall, right?
Mm-hmm.
If we want it to get sweeter, we obviously want to have more of those sugars coming in. We can get that breakdown, right, from just the taking the regular components molecules that they have there and just breaking down in simpler form, which is like kind of the sugary components in here.
So let's get the boiling ready to go. And I just put the carrots in, not very much water, and I'm just gonna bring it to boil. Okay, so here are my carrots. Here's my raw carrot, my roasted carrot, and my boiled carrot. For sure, the roasted one I think is the least colorful. So I'm gonna give them a taste. Mm-hmm. I think the salting of it also just brought out something in it too, I think.
I got caramelization when it's touching the pan. So you can see that. Yeah, that's where I got the caramelization. Yeah, the first one's the raw, this one's boiled. And then this one's the roasted. Roasted's darker to me.
Do it. So I guess that's
I know. I'm gonna try one. I'm gonna try some with salt.
Kind of agree. They are pretty bland when they're boiled. My boiled carrots I haven't gotten to the 15 marker yet, but they've changed color a lot. So the raw is the one all the way over here on the far end.
Yeah, they're like brighter, right? Like kind of brighter color. Okay, we got some oil going, so we're gonna turn our things on to like medium. So once that starts going, then we're gonna put in our some onion, right?
Yep.
And a little bit of salt, just to give it, bring out the flavor of the onions too.
Yeah, so I've added my garlic and now I'm gonna go ahead and add my spices. Is that where you guys are?
Yep, that's why I just added mine too.
Yeah, I can do that.
All right, so I think we should probably add our broth, right? Ooh, I got some cumin up my nose. Don't want them on the garlic or the spices. So I'm gonna add.
I'm gonna keep things the same myself.
Yeah, mine are getting close, so let's add carrots. Let's add carrots.
Okay.
The oil. All right, well, should we pull out some carrots, you think?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, the boiled one got the flavor, got some flavor of the onion. It's better.
With the onion and the garlic, it's like already more deep than it was just as a boiled carrot. Yeah, and then the cumin. Yeah, it's. I think it's gonna be a very edible soup, even with the boiled carrots.
I was tasting, the roasted one though, roasted one does taste like there's more flavor to it to me still.
Yeah, roasted one does taste more flavorful.
All right, ready, set, go.
Yep.
Definitely roasted one is more orange. I'm excited to see yours because yours was so much darker with your roast.
Yeah, mine almost looks like pumpkin pie color, the roasted one. So let me see if I can hold these up.
Mine almost looks like pumpkin pie too, I feel like.
Like the one on the darker one is the roasted one.
Oh yeah.
It's like so bright.
Yeah. That's
it's so
crazy.
Yellow almost.
Yeah.
All right, so we taste?
Yeah.
I was going for the roasted one first.
Roasted? Okay, let's do roasted first. Mmm. For me, it's got body. Like, it's thick, kind of like stick to the spoon thickness.
I would probably double the amount of carrots to get like a really big punch of carrot flavor. Because when they roast, they condense down so much, like relative to the rest of the soup, I think you could do easily twice as many.
Yeah, mine is very sweet.
Oh, yours is sweet?
This is very sweet.
Yours is?
Yeah, it's sweet.
Really?
Yes.
Should we taste the boiled soup this now?
Let's try it.
I love that transition. Gosh, that's seamless.
All right, I mean, for sure, mine is so much more liquidy, though. So much more liquidy. I get less carrot.
Yeah, it's more like acidic, like lemony acidic flavor and oniony flavor. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, mine is like more cumin flavor. I feel like the cumin is the dominant flavor to me in this.
The roasted one's brighter.
Yeah.
How do I equate that to something that's relative to what people, like brighter?
Deeper. Like deeper flavors.
Yeah.
Like the other one just kind of tastes like it's got the seasonings.
It's subtle, right? You have to really think about it. Like it's subtle. I can tell the carrot's there, but it's at the end. As opposed to the other one, it's like the carrot's up in front and it lasts longer.
I don't taste as much of the carrot in here. I feel like if I was looking at it, it could be anything.
Well, I taste it because originally when it started, it was woodsy and it's still earthy. So like the other one is sweeter and lasts longer in terms of taste. This one still has that woodsy profile to it.
I would say I really like the roasted one significantly better. It is for sure darker color. For sure darker color. For sure thicker, deeper flavor.
I don't dislike the boiled one as much as I thought I would, but it doesn't like scream carrot soup to me. It's just kind of like a mellow, tangy soup.
Vegetable kind of like vegetable thing. I got a little bit of an opposite result, but I think the bigger one is the fact that you can tell the difference.
Definitely.
It wasn't like to me of like, oh, does this Does this taste better or worse than the other one? I mean, there's a preference, but I mean, all serviceable.
What this really illustrates is like when you roast, you're getting a lot more chemistry happening. You're getting caramelization reactions, browning reactions. You're also losing a lot of water, right? So you're concentrating all the other things that are in the carrot that aren't water. So it's like, even though you ended up with carrots that were soft enough to blend in both cases, there's so many different things that are happening. And I think it's a good thing to keep in mind when you're cooking something that seems pretty humble, like a carrot or a sweet potato or cauliflower, broccoli, yeah.
What does it take to actually pull something out of like something that seems benign to us? Right, it's just a carrot, right? But I guess the part is you're just unlocking all these other things through process chemistry. And that I find really interesting, right? Like, how do you differentiate? It makes me think, it's like, okay, what else am I gonna do? I like the simplicity portion, right? But I don't think it was a whole lot to roast and throw things in and go from there. But like the other avenue, what can you make something good from boiled? It can be done, right?
A poached egg is pretty delicious, you know what
yeah.
I mean?
Like,
yeah.
Thank you so much for joining us. I hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit more about carrots, roasting them, and making soup. And we hope you're inspired to do it yourself. We'll see you again soon.